Hi and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to share a simple egg curry recipe. This is also called as an egg roast in Kerala. And let's start with boiling the eggs first for the egg roast. So in a pan, take water and make sure all the eggs are immersed in the water. And add a spoon of rock salt and cook this in low flame for 10 minutes. And after 10 minutes, transfer the eggs to a cold water bowl so that the cooking process will stop. And peel the eggs once it is completely cool. Please don't peel it when it is hot or else you will tend to break the eggs. So let's keep that aside and start preparing the masala. Now in a mortar and pestle, I'm going to crush a few ingredients. Take about half a teaspoon of fennel seeds and half a teaspoon of peppercorns. And first crush this to a coarse powder. Please don't use a mixer jar for this process because crushing and adding will give an altogether a different flavor to your curry. Now add about 4 garlic cloves and a small piece of ginger and crush this well and keep this aside. Now take a wider pan for the masala. Add about 4 spoons of oil. Once the oil is nice and hot, we are going to add about 1 spoon of the crushed ingredient. That is, we are adding all the crushed ingredients to the oil and wait for the raw smell to leave. So once this is cooked through completely, it's time to add the onions. So for 5 eggs, I've taken about 4 large onions and I've cut this into lengthwise. You can also cut it into smaller pieces if you like it that way. And the only lengthy thing in this process is cooking the onions through, because we are using a lot of onions for this masala. Cooking of the onions will definitely take some time, say about 8 to 10 minutes. So please be a little patient and make sure you cook this through completely. Only once the onions are cooked and once the raw smell goes, the gravy will be even more flavorful. So you can also add a spoon of salt at this point to fasten the cooking of the onions. So the onions have to nicely turn color and it has to reduce. So add about half a teaspoon of turmeric powder to the oil itself and curry leaves. Adding this to the oil will give an amazing flavor to your curry. So cook this through for another 5 to 8 minutes. I'm adding 1 green chili here. This is not that spicy, so I'm just adding it for a flavor. So now it's time to add the spice powder. So onions are completely cooked through. Now it's time to add the spice powder. So add about 2 spoons of coriander powder and then 2 spoons of chili powder. You can also use Kashmiri chili powder for color for your gravy, and then half a teaspoon of garam masala. Mix this well in low flame and make sure you don't burn the spices. Give a quick mix. And now it's time to add the tomatoes. I'm just using 1 tomato here. Please don't use more than that or else curry will have a tangy flavor. You will not be able to feel the taste and sweetness of the onions actually. Cook this through completely until the tomatoes are nice and soft. I'm just going to cover and let this cook for another 2 minutes. After 2 minutes, let's check the masala. So if you can see, the tomatoes are nicely turned soft and mushy, and the gravy is a little dry, so you can add water at this point. I'm just adding about 1/4 cup of water and then add salt for the gravy. Mix this well, and finally I'm adding about 1/2 a spoon of jaggery. You can also use sugar. This will actually help to balance the flavors in your egg masala. So it's cooked through, the gravy is done. So now it's time to add the eggs. I have slit the eggs on all the sides and I'm just going to add it. You can also cut the eggs into halves if you're planning to make sandwiches using this. After adding the eggs, just cover and let this cook for another minute and your egg roast is done. So this is a perfect combination for any type of Indian breads. You can also use it with some variety rice like lemon rice, tomato rice and ghee rice. And this can also be used as a filling for your sandwiches. So a very easy and a very straightforward recipe. Please do try and leave your comments below. And follow the recipe as it is, and definitely you will enjoy it. Thank you for watching, and please don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel.